Welcome to a lesson on Newton's method. The goal of this video is to use Newton's method to approximate real zeros of a function. Newton's method is a technique for approximating the real zeros of a function that uses tangent lines to approximate the graph near its x-intercepts. While Newton's method is a fairly straightforward procedure to follow, it is important to realize what is happening graphically when we use Newton's method. So let's take a look. Let's say we were trying to approximate the real zero of this graph, which would be the x value of this x-intercept. But instead of doing it algebraically, we wanted to approximate it using tangent lines. What we would do is start with an initial guess. Let's say we thought it was around 2.5. At this location, we would sketch the tangent line to the function, as we see here in red. And we would determine the zero, or the x-intercept of the tangent line, to approximate the real zero of the original function. And you can see that the real zero of this tangent line is very close to the real zero of the blue function. Now, if our initial guess for the zero of the function was not as good, you can see that the zero of the tangent line would not be as close to the true zero of the function as we might want. So what we could do is repeat this process and use this as our next approximation. And if we use this x value to sketch an additional tangent line, you can see that the zero of the next tangent line becomes a better approximation, and we can continue this process if we wanted to. Let's change the function now to determine what else can happen. Notice with this initial guess, it would take several tries for the zeros of the tangent lines to come very close to the zeros of the original function. Here's our first tangent line. Here's our second tangent line, third tangent line, and then finally our fourth tangent line is a very good approximation. So this initial guess is important, that it's fairly close to a real zero of the function if we want this to work out well. Here's an example of where we have a bad initial guess. If we're looking for this real zero, you can see how the second tangent line would have a zero that's way off to the right. But this is the main idea of Newton's method. We're going to find the zero of a tangent line to approximate the real zero of the original function. So if we let f(x)1 be a point on a function near the x-intercept, then the equation of the tangent line would look like this in point-slope form, where f(x)1 is the slope of the tangent line. Now remember, if you want to find the zero or x-intercept of a line, you set y = 0 and solve for x. Let's go ahead and try to do this with this line. We'll set y = 0, and now we'll solve for x. What we'll do first is divide by f(x)1. So this simplifies to negative f(x)1 divided by f(x)1 equals x - x(1). So now we can just add x(1) to both sides. So we would have x equals x(1) - f(x)1 divided by f(x)1. And this is actually the formula that we will use to apply Newton's method, where x(1) was our initial guess, and this x here would be the next approximation to the real zero. Let's go ahead and formalize this. If f(c) = 0, then to approximate c, we can use the following steps. We make an initial estimate x(1) that is close to c. A graph is helpful to determine this guess if not given. And then to determine a new approximation, we're going to use this equation that we just derived, which would be the zero of the tangent line when x = x(1). So notice if this is x(1), this would be x(2), or the new approximation. Then, if the difference of the approximations is within the desired accuracy, we can let x(n)(1) serve as our final approximation. So let's go ahead and give this a try. What we're going to do here is organize all the information in a table, and we'll also be using the graphing calculator. So this first column, n, represents the number of iterations. So this will be 1, 2, 3, and 4. And what we're going to do is use Newton's method to approximate the real zero close to x = 1, so that'll be our initial approximation, until two successive approximations differ by less than 0.005. So x sub 1 is going to be equal to 1. Next, we're going to evaluate the function at 1, evaluate the derivative at 1, evaluate this quotient, and then this is the formula that will give us our new approximation. Instead of doing this all by hand, we're going to use the graphing calculator. So let's go ahead and get that out. We're going to type in the function into y1. In y2, we're going to type in the derivative. So the derivative would be 4x. For y3, we'll use the calculator to evaluate this quotient. So we'll have the function divided by the derivative, which would be y1 divided by y2. So we'll press vars, yvars, enter. Again, our numerator will be y1, the function, divided by y2, which is our derivative. So press vars, right arrow, enter, down once, and then enter. And the last column is going to be x minus this quotient. So we'll have x minus y3, because y3 is the quotient. So we have x minus vars, right arrow, enter, down to y3, press enter. Now the last thing we have to do is make sure that our table feature is on ask. So press second window, make sure the independent variable is on ask. So now we'll go to our table feature and just complete this table. So second graph, we'll type in x equals 1. So y1 is our function value, that's negative 1. The value of the derivative is y2, that's 4. Now we'll scroll over to y3, and we'll go ahead and show y4 as well. These last two columns are negative 0.25 and 1.25. So again, what happened, 1 was our initial approximation, and then we subtracted this quotient, and this quotient was negative 0.25. So we subtracted a negative 1.25. 1.25 is our next approximation. So we'll take this value of 1.25, and now we'll do the exact same thing again. So we'll go down to the second row, and now we'll type in 1.25 and fill out the table again. So the function value is 0.125 and the derivative value is 5. Let's record that. So notice how the function value is getting closer to 0. Next, we need to find the value of this quotient and then our next approximation. And we'll find those two values in y3 and y4. So 0.025 and 1.225. So notice how our second approximation is not that much different than 1.25, which we found from the first iteration. The difference here is still more than 0.005. So we'll go ahead and do this again. This will be our next approximation for the 0. And we'll go ahead and go back to our table. Let's go down to the third row. And now we'll type in 1.225. And notice how, again, the function value is getting very close to 0 now. So we have 0.00125 for the function value and 4.9 for the derivative. Now we'll find the quotient and our next approximation. So we'll scroll over to y3 and y4. Now notice y3 is now in scientific notation. So we have to move the decimal 4 places to the left. So 0.00026. And our next approximation is 1.2247. If we wanted to do another iteration, this would be our next approximation. However, the difference between the previous approximation and the new approximation is less than 0.005. Therefore, we can stop and say that using Newton's method, our approximation will be 1.2247. And that should make sense because if you look at the function value, it's very close to 0. So this is a very good approximation for the 0 of the original function near x equals 1. Of course, we could have crunched all these numbers by hand, but I hope you'll agree that using the table feature of the graphing calculator is a good use of technology in this case. And if we want to use Newton's method to approximate a real 0 of any other function, the process here would be exactly the same. I hope you found this video helpful.